Hello, I'm Chris Kelly, Applications Engineer with Keysight Technologies, and I'm going to discuss the Internet of Things challenges that you may have in manufacturing test of these tiny IoT devices. There's going to be billions of them all over the world in a variety of functions, from parking sensors to barbecue grills. Some companies are experienced adding RF is an old thing to them, but others are new at this. And I see there's around five big test challenges that companies may face in adding Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, or other RF technologies, these wireless technologies, to their products. It could end up being costly if you choose certain routes. But in response to this need for multiple low-cost solutions, Keysight Technologies has introduced a new product that is simpler, less costly, particularly aimed at the manufacturing test zone of electronic test, and gives you both hardware and software with easily configured reports. This new product, the X8711A, should be something you'd consider for all your new production test systems. So the first challenge I'm going to pose is, my company is new to RF test. This is common to many companies. Wireless is being added to a number of different products that hasn't been wireless before. I mentioned the barbecue grill, parking measurements, home automation. There's going to be a lot of companies adding wireless that this is a new area for them. There's just not enough in-house RF expertise to plan and design all of these tests. Further, I'm going to need a pretty complete test solution in this production test set. I need it to be flexible so that multiple products of my product line, similar types, can be tested, Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. And I'd like to use normal modes of wireless operation in doing that, and test for the kinds of problems I'm going to see in manufacturing. Again, misloaded parts, bad solder, missing parts. The new Keysight solution is an inexpensive test solution that can test these small wireless devices. It includes an RF test card, software to configure, to run, and to report the results of that test. The precision measurement that needed to be done in R&D and design verification may not be needed in manufacturing. So we're going to be looking for these manufacturing defects only, and this inexpensive solution is able to do that. The second challenge in testing wireless modules is writing code, special test code, that goes into your wireless module that does not represent normal operation. It'll make your module be doing things that you would not do, like making an unmodulated carrier to make an RF power sense, or reading back registers inside of that device under test, measuring signal strength or error rate, something like that. So this method of loading special code has a number of drawbacks. First of all, you need to write more software just to get that done. That takes time. Second, you need to load this special software into your module. Well, using what port? If you have a tiny little module like this, or maybe even a hearing aid, you have no second port to load and unload that code. So it's too small for a test connector. Then you're not testing your production software. You're making the device do something it would not normally do. You have more software to maintain. You have your normal software and you have your test software. If you have a failure, where's the problem? And then the reloading process, or loading and unloading process, takes more production time and is itself a source of possible errors. The new Keysight solution can measure these RF signals without needing a special code, using normal on-the-air behavior. The third challenge in testing IoT devices is the question of, must I test all RF parameters? You know, by the time I've reached manufacturing, I have been through some very precise parametric tests in R&D. I've been through tests in design verification. Through these cycles, I've measured that my device is correctly designed. And really what I need to do now is do a quantitative measurement on transmit and receive to catch the kinds of defects that are likely to happen in manufacturing. These might be solder connection to an antenna. It might be a misloaded component, either the wrong value or in the wrong place, or completely missing. And to catch these kinds of problems is a little easier with a simpler test system. Our digital age gives us very repeatable results on digital signals, so I'm really concerned with the analog levels of RF that are going on here at the end of my production cycle. These innovative techniques that the new test systems can do test what matters most to manufacturing without requiring those invasive probes. Again, we can do quantitative measurements of transmit power and receive sensitivity without having to get into the device and cause special code to be executed. In an inexpensive way, a test system can do all of that without requiring large investments in RF test gear. The fourth challenge to manufacturing test of IoT devices is cost. The IoT devices are going to be so numerous, they're literally scaled already to billions, and your devices may have very high volumes. So you'll need a solution that is relatively low cost and scalable, so when your volumes ramp, you don't have a huge reinvestment with each new line. What if you could cut the cost of your test in half? The new Keysight solution combines both data acquisition and RF test modules into a flexible and inexpensive test solution that is easily reproduced at low cost on your manufacturing line. It measures transmit and receive performance quantitatively, and it includes test automation software to make the process of designing these tests and executing these tests rather simple. So the fifth and final test that I'm posing for you today is that golden radio is not sufficient. The definition of a golden radio test varies. It might be fairly complex, a truly golden test, or it might be rather simple. If it connects, it passes. But this low end may not be sufficient. For example, successfully pairing a Bluetooth device is not an adequate test. It can succeed in a Bluetooth connect even if your signals are 20 dB or more below where they should be. So trying to do a detection of faulty units is hit and miss. Faulty units can escape, get out on the market, and suddenly your company has a bad rep. If it has a very short range, your customers are going to know it. So avoid damage to your reputation and the cost of a potential recall. Do some quantitative measurements on your devices. The way this will happen then is you'll put your devices through a number of tests, develop some statistics for where pass-fail limits ought to be, and go on with the test using something like the Keysight X8711A low-cost manufacturing test equipment. So this new world of IoT devices is generating tiny devices in huge numbers. And some organizations are finding the addition of this wireless capability is leading them into unfamiliar territory of RF measurements. Others are finding their manufacturing tests being taxed by the huge volumes that they're trying to do. If you think of an innovative test solution like the Keysight X8711A, you can get a low cost and high volume solution that does sufficient measurement that your IoT devices can go out on the market with confidence that they'll operate correctly. Thank you for watching.